Hi students, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please click the like button, share and subscribe. In this video, I am explaining the solution of exercise 3.1, question number 3, 4 and 5. Chapter 3, trigonometric functions. So question number 3, a wheel makes 360 revolutions in 1 minute. Through how many radians does it turn in 1 second? See, in the question, they have given that there is a wheel and the wheel makes 360 revolutions in 1 minute. So now here, we need to find out how many radians does it turn in 1 second. So we know that in 1 minute, the wheel makes 360 revolution. Then how many revolution the wheel make in 1 second, that we have to find out. See, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So, to find out the number of revolutions in 1 second, divide 60. 360 must be divided by 60. So, 1 second is equal to 360 divided by 60 because we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So, 0 get cancelled. 6 ones are, 6 six are. So, we get here the answer 6. So, in 1 second, the wheel makes 6 revolutions. So now we come to know that the wheel makes 6 revolutions in 1 second. And then wheel means it is in the form of circle. And you know that in the circle when one complete rotation or revolutions occur, then that is nothing but 360 degree angle. The one complete rotation will create 360 degree angle. So that one rotation is nothing but one revolution. So here in 1 second, the wheel makes 6 revolution. So we need to find out now the total number of angle created by the 6 revolution. So 360 degree into 6 you can make. Because in one revolution or in one rotation, we can have 360 degree angle. Here we have 6 revolutions. So 360 degree into 6. So here we got 2160 degree. So the wheel make 2160 degree angle in 6 revolution. But this particular answer is in degree measure. And in the question, they have told that we need to find the answer in radians. So now you have to convert this particular answer in radians. So to convert this answer in radians, we can use the formula radian measure is equal to pi by 180 into degree measure. So pi by 180 into 2160. So here you can perform the cancellation and here after cancellation, we get the answer 12 pi radian. So, the final answer is 12 pi radians. So, this is about question number 3. Next here, we will discuss question number 4. The question number 4 is, find the degree measure of the angle subtended at the center of a circle of radius 100 cm by an arc of length 22 cm. Use pi is equal to 22 by 7. See here, in the question they have given that we need to find out degree measure. So when you are finding the degree measure and in the formula, if you find the pi value, then that pi value you need to replace with 22 by 7. See what and all things they have given here? They have mentioned that the degree measure of the angle subtended at the center of a circle of radius 100 cm. So they have given us the radius. The radius is 100 cm, the radius of the circle. By an arc of the length. The length of the arc is also given here, that is 22 cm. So here in this question, they have mentioned that there is a circle and the radius of the circle is 100 cm and the length of the arc is 22 cm. So here, when we know the length of the arc and radius, then we can join this line and then the angle is produced and that angle is nothing but theta. So we need to find out now the theta angle in degree measure form. See here, we know the radius. Radius r is equal to 100 cm. If this is 100 cm, then this line is also 100 cm as this is nothing but the radius of the circle. Wherever you draw the line, that is 100 cm only. That is not going to change. So here, this is radius is 100 cm. Then length of the arc, that is also given, that is 22 cm. Now we know the radius and length of the arc. So we need to find out the theta angle. So theta is equal to L by R. We know this formula. So 22 divided by 100, 22, again here you can perform the cancellation. So here 2 11s are 22 and then 2 50s are 100. So we get the answer 11 by 50. See, this 11 by 50 answer is in radian. Whenever you find anything by using the formula theta is equal to L by R, then whatever the answer is generated, that answer is in radians. So in the question, they have told that you need to find the answer in degree measure. That means now this particular answer you need to convert in degree measure. So to convert the given radians into degree, the formula is degree measure is equal to 180 by pi into radian measure. So 180 by pi into radian measure value we know 11 by 50. 11 by 50. See now as we are finding here degree measure, if you find the pi value, then just replace that pi value with 22 by 7. So 180 divided by 22 by 7 into 11 by 50. So here this will come up. So we get here 180 into 7 by 22 into 11 by 50. So now you can perform the cancellation here. And after all the cancellation here, we get the final answer 63 by 5. But this particular answer, this answer is not in degree form. You know that in degree we have degree, minutes and seconds. This is a fraction. So now here we need to find out this particular answer, or we need to convert this answer in degree form. So to convert this answer in degree form, just perform the division. So when you perform the division, so here 5 ones are 5, so here we get 13, then again 5 twos are 10, so here we get here 3. So quotient is 12, divisor is 5 and remainder is 3. So now after performing the division, you got this answer, quotient, divisor and remainder. So now you write this answer in QRD form. QRD means first write down the quotient. Quotient is 12 here, 12 degree. Then remainder and then divisor. So remainder is 3 here and divisor is 5. So now this is in degree. This is also in degree. So this particular value, it is in between 12 degree and 13 degree. So that we need to convert in now minutes. So how we can convert the given degree to minutes? We know that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So just multiply 60 to this. So 3 by 5 into 60. So we get here after cancellation, the final answer is 36 minutes. So when you multiply 60 to this, then this become minute. So after cancellation here we get 36, that is in minute. So here we get the final answer as 12 degree 36 minute. So this is about the fourth question. Next here we will discuss the fifth question. The fifth question is, in a circle of diameter 40 cm, the length of a chord is 20 cm. Find the length of minor arc of the chord. See, chord means, suppose if you have a circle, let us say that you have a circle and this is the center point. Generally, chord means if there are two points on the circle, if you take any two points and if there is a line joining those two points, then that particular line we can call as a chord. So now here, in this case, see, you can't consider the center line as the center line is a radius. Other than the center line, all other lines you can consider. So now here we need to find out, they have given us diameter. Diameter is 40 centimeter. If you know the diameter, you can find the radius, right? The radius is half of the diameter. So we know the diameter, that is 40 centimeter. That means radius is equal to 20 centimeter. Then next here, the length of a chord is 20 centimeter. They have given the length of the chord. Then find the length of the minor arc of the chord. We need to find out the length of the minor arc of the chord. See, here in this question, we know that the diameter of the circle is, consider a circle, draw a circle first. The diameter of the circle is 40 centimeter. From this, we can find the radius. So the radius of the circle is 20 centimeter. Then next, they have given the length of the chord. The chord means the line which connects two points. So here, let us say that there is a point here. And if I draw a line here, then the theta angle is produced here. And now if I connect this A and B point, then I can call these two point line as a chord, as here this particular line connects two points on the circle. So now this is a chord. We know the length of the chord as 20 centimeter. They have already given. And then as I have joined here this line to this, see, this is nothing but the radius of the circle, right? We know that radius of the circle is 20 centimeter. So this is also 20 centimeter now. So now here we got one triangle, and this triangle is nothing but, see, this is 20 centimeter, this is 20 centimeter, and this is 20 centimeter. So all the sides are equal. In which triangle all the sides are equal? In the equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal. So here, and not only that one, if all the sides are equal means the angle, all angle must be equal to 60 degree. So now here we can say that this is 60 degree, this is 60 degree, and this is 60 degree. And this particular triangle is nothing but equilateral triangle. See, here equilateral triangle we can get from this, as here the side of the triangle is equal to 20 centimeter. All the sides are equal here. So we got here equilateral triangle. Now see, in the equilateral triangle we know that the angle is 60 degrees. So here even we got now theta angle. So that angle theta is equal to 60 degree here. And then next here, next thing is that this is in degree form, but we need the particular answer in radian form. Always the theta angle is measured in radian, but here we got the answer in degree. So now the given degree value you have to convert in radians. So how we can convert the given value in radians? Radian measure is equal to pi by 180 into degree measure. So pi by 180 into 60. So perform the cancellation. After cancellation, we get the answer pi by 3 radians. So here we got the theta value, which is in radian. Theta is equal to pi by 3 radians. Next here, see, we know now theta value. Theta is pi by 3 radians. Then next, we know the R value. The R is nothing but the radius of the circle, which is 20 centimeter. Now we need to find out length of the minor arc of the chord. Minor arc means what? See, if you have a circle, let us say that you have a circle, and then this is the radius of the circle, and you have drawn one line over here. Now here, this particular part is known as a minor arc, where it will create a small angle, and then this particular part is known as a major arc. So now we need to find out the length of the minor arc. That means in this particular circle, you need to find out length of this particular arc. As we, this is a minor arc and this one is a major arc. So this length we need to find out. So to find the length of the arc, we know the formula theta is equal to L by R. See, here we know the theta value. Theta is equal to pi by 3. And also we know R, radius is equal to 20 centimeter. So just interchange the values here, units here. L is equal to theta into R. So L is equal to pi by 3 into 20. So here we get the answer 20 pi by 3 centimeter. This unit, the unit of this length is centimeter. So L is equal to 20 pi by 3 centimeter. So this is about question number 3, 4 and 5 of exercise 3.1. If you like this video, please click the like button and also subscribe to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor for more regular updates. Thanks for watching.